Hey everybody, it's Monday. Today's topic is, why are we getting beat up? Why are we feeling old and creaky with our joints hurting and feeling stiff in the morning? Maybe some of that is just age and you can't really do anything about it. But I mean, if you're in your 20s, even 30s or 40s, and you're already feeling that way, and I've been there, I'm 38 and you know, I've had days like that too. But if you're that young and feeling that way, I don't think that's really normal, or it shouldn't be. But why is it happening? Well, two possible things that are major things outside of, you know, just being injured. If you're somebody that doesn't work out or move that much, your job doesn't require that much movement of you, then it's probably more disuse. It's because your body has gotten kind of stuck in the positions and shapes that it's in, and it doesn't like moving outside of that. But that means you're losing capacity, and that's not really a good thing. I think most of us know that, but we don't really pay attention to it until our body starts to give us those warning signals. You know, the check engine light comes on and we start to say, oh man, my shoulder doesn't feel so good anymore, or my back, or whatever. And then we start to pay attention and then start to look for solutions. The other thing could be that you are somebody that works out a lot and you're doing the same movements over and over and over. So then it's not disuse, it's overuse. And that's very common too. And it's very predictable in terms of what types of injuries you're going to see from certain sports or activities. If you do jiu-jitsu, you're pretty likely to end up with some knee problems. If you're a runner, you're probably going to have, you know, plantar fasciitis. And shin splints is a good bet. If you play tennis, you're probably going to have some elbow issues. If you like to bench press a lot, you're probably going to have shoulder problems. All of these things are pretty predictable because the body doesn't like to do the same movement over and over and over again. It's not that any of those movements or activities are bad. It's just that our body is not a machine in the sense that we can't do the same thing over and over again without breaking down. So in either case, what's the solution? I think a good option is to increase your movement variety, and that means doing things that you don't normally do. And if it is a workout, then, you know, try some different things. If it's, weightlifting that you normally do, try to incorporate some new exercises, different planes of motion, especially if you're somebody that, you know, only ever does, very balanced, symmetrical looking type movements, you know, back squats, bench presses, curls. Try some stuff that gets you out of that linear path. Try some stuff that incorporates more sideways movement, some rotation. Now, you know, you have to know what you're doing. I'm not saying just go bananas in there and start making stuff up, but there's lots of good movements that are unconventional that will give you a lot of benefit. And it's not that you have to throw out all the other stuff that's been working for you or that you like, but incorporating more variety is very good for the body. And then same thing if you're into your sport training and that's starting to break you down a little bit. If you get out and try some cross training, I mean, athletes have known that cross training is good for them for, you know, decades. I mean, that's been something that's been around since, I don't know, the early 1900s, I think. And all it takes is, you know, a couple extra sessions a week of doing something outside of your sport. You know, if you're somebody that is always, you know, running, try some yoga. If you're somebody that is always, you know, doing, I don't know, I always think of the sports I do, rock climbing, you know, maybe try some type of a cardio-based thing. Try some kickboxing or boxing. There's a whole world of movements out there, and it doesn't mean you have to become, you know, a specialist in these other things and give up your sport that you love, but just include a little bit of variety. Variety is the spice of life, as they say. So just some food for thought on Monday. If you're dealing with or have dealt with some aches and pains from overuse, or even if you're not sure, leave me a comment down below, and I'd love to hear what you've experienced and if you've found a a solution, or if this message resonates with you, let me know. Take care and have a great week, everybody.